Hey there, I'm Josh Clark, and this is the Brain Stuff where we do Pop Rocks. You know Pop Rocks, that awesome little bag of candies that you put on your tongue and they explode? Pop Rocks. Well, have you heard some of the rumors behind it? Like, you know, if you eat Pop Rocks and drink Coke at the same time, your head will blow up? Or that the kid who played Mikey in the Life cereal commercials died from that very lethal combination? These are just dirty lies. But Pop Rocks do pop, and I'm here to tell you why. So the ingredients list in Pop Rocks is pretty innocuous. You've got sugar, corn syrup, water, and flavorings. Bam, that's it, right? Doesn't seem like anything really mysterious in there. But let's go through the process of making Pop Rocks. Maybe we'll find the key. I think we will. So you take these ingredients, these very innocuous ingredients, and you mix them together and heat them up. And that dissolves all the sugars in the Pop Rocks. You take that mixture, you boil it so that all the water is evaporated out, leaving you with this gooey, pure, sugary syrup. You gasify the sugar mixture and you pump in 600 pounds per square inch of CO2, carbon dioxide. Now we've reached the magic ingredient. As this sugar mixture cools and hardens, it turns brittle, and all of that pressure shatters the Pop Rocks into rocks, right? But that leaves some of the CO2 trapped inside, and that is the mystery ingredient. So, Pop Rocks are pretty stable up to a certain temperature, but when they are introduced to your tongue, your warm saliva melts them, and that releases the CO2 bubbles trapped inside, leading to them popping. That's how Pop Rocks works. Pretty cool, huh? You want to hear something else pretty neat about Pop Rocks? They're actually rated for poppability. Before they leave the factory, a testing panel rates the things on a scale of 0 to 14. Who knew? 0 is like no pop whatsoever, 14 is maximum popping. And any Pop Rock that's rated under a 7 doesn't pass muster and doesn't make it out of the factory. I imagine they just kind of shovel those in their mouths as they're raiding the other ones, right? So what about the rumors? What about Mikey from Life and his head blowing up from drinking Coke and eating Pop Rocks at the same time? Untrue, as I said. But something crazy did happen with Pop Rocks back in 1979. Newsweek ran an article about a shipment of Pop Rocks that was being transported, and it went above the transport temperature of 85 degrees Fahrenheit. All the Pop Rocks melted at about the same time and blew the doors of the delivery truck wide open. That actually happened. So Pop Rocks aren't gonna blow your head off, but back in the 80s, there were enough rumors swirling around about it that apparently the company responsible for making Pop Rocks sent 50,000 letters to school principals all over the country, and a hotline was set up for anxious parents who could call it and have their fears assuaged that, yes, your kid can eat Pop Rocks. No, his head's not gonna blow up. He may or may not get diabetes or obesity, but he should probably survive the initial contact with Pop Rocks. So that's Pop Rocks for you. You have any memories, experiences with Pop Rocks? Leave them in the comments below. We love that kind of thing. And what's it gonna kill you if you subscribe to Brain Stuff? You like this video? There's tons more where this one came from. Brain Stuff.